Hello everyone, sorry it's been a few weeks, but we're back again with more videos. Today we're taking a look at the Ukraine DOS virus, and this virus is actually fairly complex and employs a number of stealth techniques to avoid detection. So we'll go ahead and run it, and it tells us it's a goat file, and we won't actually see it infecting files, even though it does so. So graphics.com, as usual, is 19,742 bytes. When we run it, the virus will infect it. However, it uses stealth techniques, as I said, to hide these effects. You can see the amount of bytes free decreased by the size of the Ukraine virus from 809.792 to 805.696, but we don't see the actual file size increase in our directory listing. The same thing goes for exe files, which it also infects. And we'll just jump right to the payload, which activates on the 24th of any month. So we'll advance the date by one day. And when we go and run any infected file, we get the Ukrainian flag, some nice music, and if I could display Cyrillic characters, you would see it, but right now it's just gibberish. And I guess the song repeats now. Hitting keys doesn't do anything, but we can restart with Control-Alt-Delete. We'll go ahead and do so. And while the computer is booting, you may have noticed the refresh rate was actually pretty nice for that whole thing. There wasn't any seizure-inducing flickering going on. It's actually a utility written and sent to me by TheGreatCodeholio. And more on that in a bit. So as we can see, we try to boot, and nothing happens. All of our data is gone, partition table is wiped. Basically, you have to remake the disk from scratch in fdisk, and you lose all your data. So, you get the Ukrainian flag and a nice song, and then you lose everything. So, kind of a pain. You know, losing data is never fun, but it's a nice, pretty interesting virus. I always like viruses that have songs in them, and this one's a good example of that. So, thank you for watching. Take it easy. Oh right, I said I was going to say more about the great code Holio. He actually wrote a utility that makes DOS run in 60 Hz, so it matches up with the 60 frames per second of my camera. So there's no more seizure-inducing flickering as long as that program can run. So check out his channel and the link to his GitHub in the video description. And now that's really about it. Take care.